जय हिंद स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी स्टार्ट अवर थर्ड यूनिट इलेक्ट्रोकेमिस्ट्री। फर्स्ट वी सी व्हाट इज इलेक्ट्रोकेमिस्ट्री। इलेक्ट्रोकेमिस्ट्री इज द ब्रांच ऑफ केमिस्ट्री इन विच वी डील्स विद द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन द इलेक्ट्रिकल एनर्जी एंड द केमिकल एनर्जी। वी स्टडी द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन द इलेक्ट्रिकल एनर्जी एंड केमिकल एनर्जी एंड हाउ द इलेक्ट्रिकल एनर्जी कन्वर्ट इनटू केमिकल एनर्जी एंड केमिकल एनर्जी कन्वर्ट इनटू इलेक्ट्रिकल एनर्जी। इनडायरेक्टली इंटर कन्वर्शन ऑफ वन फॉर्म ऑफ एनर्जी इनटू अनदर फॉर्म इज नोन एज इलेक्ट्रोकेमिस्ट्री। आफ्टर दिस वी सी द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ मैटर। क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ मैटर आइदर सब्सटेंसेस। सो ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ पासेज ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी on the basis of passage of electricity substances we classify into three types. First is called conductor. Conductor are those substances which passes the electric current through them are called conductors. Example is metals. Second is insulators. Insulators are those substances which not passes the current or not conduct the electricity, passes the electric current, are known as insulator. Third is semiconductor. Semiconductors are the intermediate between the conductor and insulator. So semiconductor are those substance which low temperature behave as a insulator, that is not passes the electric current, but at a higher temperature, if we rise the temperature, behave as a conductors, are known as semiconductor. So on the basis of passage of electric current or conductivity of current, substances we classify three types. First is we called conductor. Those substances which pass the electric current through them are called conductor. Second we see insulator. Insulator are those substances which does not pass the electric current through them are called insulator. Example plastic, rubber, wood. Third is the semiconductor. Semiconductors are the intermediate between the conductor and insulator. So those substances at low temperature behave as an insulator, but at higher temperature act as a conductor, we call semiconductor. Germanium, silicon behave as a semiconductor. Now we see the classification of conductors. In conductor example is the metals and electrolyte. So on this basis conductors we classified into two types. See the classification of conductors. Now conductors we classified into two types on the basis of passes of electric current. First is called metallic conductor and second is called electrolytic conductors. Two types, metallic conductors and electrolytic conductors. Metallic conductors are those substances which passes electric current through the movement of ions, through the movements of electrons, passes electric current through the movement of electrons, through the movements of electrons. We know that metals are those substance which loses the electron and form positive ion. So they passes the electric current through the movement of electrons. That's why this type of conductance we called electronic conductance. And there is the no transfer of the substance are known as metallic conductor. And such type of conductance is called electronic or metallic conductance. Electrolyte are those substances which passes the electric current passes the electric current through ions. They pass the electricity through the movement of ions. That's why this type of conductance we call ionic conductance. We call the ionic conductance. So conductors, which type of current they passes, we classify two types. First is called metallic conductors and second we call the electrolytic conductors. Metallic conductors are those in which we pass the electricity through the movements of ions, and that's why it is called electronic conductance. And secondly, electrolytic conductance are those in which the electricity is passed through the movement of ions. So it is called ionic conductance. Now, after this, we see the electrolyte. In this unit, we study electrolyte. So what is electrolyte? We see first, electrolyte are those substances. Electrolyte are those substances which passes the electric current either in their molten state or in their aqueous conditions. They passes the electric current through their molten state, if we melted the substance molten state, or in their aqueous condition, in their aqueous solution, are known as electrolytes. And the electric current in such type of substance is passes through the movement of ions. So on the basis of degree of ionization, electrolyte we divide into two types. First is called strong electrolyte and second we called weak electrolyte. Strong electrolyte are those substances which are completely ionized in their aqueous solution, which are completely dissociate or ionized in their aqueous condition. We call it strong electrolyte, and the conductance is higher because the number of ions is greater in strong electrolyte. Example, all strong acid or bases. All strong acid, HCl. All strong bases, NaOH, KOH, and their salts also. Sodium acetate, these are the strong electrolyte. Second is called weak electrolyte. Weak electrolytes are those substances which is not completely ionized in their aqueous condition, very partially or not completely ionized in their aqueous solutions are called weak electrolyte. And their ionic conductance value is very, very less. For example, weak acid, suppose acetic acid, weak base, NH4, so these are the electrolytes. So electrolytes are the those substances we conduct the electricity in their molten state, either in their aqueous condition. If we dissolve the electrolyte into solution, they give the ions. So on the basis of degree of ionization, electrolyte we classify into two types, strong electrolyte and the weak electrolyte. Strong electrolytes are those which are completely ionized in their aqueous conditions, are called strong electrolyte, and there the electrical conductance value is so much higher because they give the large number of ions. Secondly, weak electrolyte are those which are partially or very less ionized in their solution, are called weak electrolyte, and their electrical conductance value is also very less. So we see first, on the basis of substances, electric current, substance classified three types, conductor, insulator and semiconductor. Secondly, we classified conductors, metallic conductor and electrolytic conductor. Thirdly, classified electrolyte, strong electrolyte and weak electrolyte. And next is the non-electrolyte. So non-electrolytes are those substances which does not conduct the electricity in their molten state or in their aqueous condition are called non-electrolyte. For example, urea, glucose, sugar, etc.